He used race to divide us from the very beginning. From the racist birther lie that the former president Barack Obama was not born in this country, to both sides in Charlottesville, to dancing around the question of whether he disavowed the former leader of the Ku Klux Klan.
There's a lot to unpack. First, let's talk about the birther lie. Again, John Heilman, the co-author of the book Game Change, he's a lefty. He is conceding that, no, it was the Hillary campaign that questioned whether or not Barack Obama was from Africa.
With her and her campaign passing things around in the Democratic primary, Rich, now listen.
He says he is.
The Republicans are wrong for doing what they're doing. It started, this started with Hillary Clinton, and it was spread by the Clinton team.
We're just telling
back
the truth.
In 2008.
But Joe Scarborough, along with Mika Brzezinski, saying that it was Hillary who started it. One of the other panelists, a guy named Harold Ford. Harold Ford is a former congressman from Tennessee, a Democrat, and he had no idea that it was a Hillary campaign that started it. He was flummoxed. Also on the same panel was John Heilman, who later on had to be encouraged to come in and confirm or dispute the assertion. And he said, unfortunately, it is true. Hillary's campaign started it.
I don't believe.
Nika, you can't tell me.
This is Harold Ford. What?
Stop when you are, when the two of you are making comments. It'd be different if you have a, if there's a basis, an actual evidentiary basis for what you're saying, then I would agree with.
They're the ones that spread it in 2008?
I don't recall that, but if you're telling me that was the case, I just don't recall.
John, you don't recall that. Think about this. I don't recall that. That's because he watches CNN, he watches MSNBC, he reads the New York Times, he doesn't watch any other alternative news. He had no idea that it was a Hillary campaign that did this.
The basis, an actual evidentiary basis for what you're saying, then I would agree with.
If you had any evidence behind it, then that's one thing. But you know, what's your basis for saying this? You think Morning Joe and Mika just made it up?
You're making comments. It'd be different if you have a, if there's a basis, an actual evidentiary basis for what you're saying, then I would.
Now, if this guy is a former elected Democrat congressman, has no idea that the Hillary campaign started the birther movement, then how do you suppose everybody else feels? This guy ought to be pretty knowledgeable. Works on Wall Street. He's a lawyer. Has no blooming idea.
They're the ones that spread it in 2008?
I don't recall that, but if you're telling me that was the case, I just don't recall.
John Heilman.
It was the case.
Thank you, John Heilman.
And didn't she go on 60 Minutes and not actually say no? She said, well, he says he is.
I'm offering my rule.
What was that?
I'm affirming the Scarborough Brzezinski.
Okay, do you know about the assertion?
Sigh. The other thing that Lemon said is Donald Trump would not renounce the head of the KKK, would not renounce David Duke. He wouldn't.
Well, you've got David Duke just joined, a bigot, a racist, a problem. I mean, this is not exactly the people you want in your party.
Yeah, David Duke and all were disavowed. I disavowed him on Friday. I disavowed him right after that because I thought if there was any question.
I didn't even know he endorsed me. David Duke endorsed me? Okay. All right. I disavow, okay?
I disavowed David Duke, and I disavowed him the day before at a major news conference. David Duke is a bad person who I disavowed on numerous occasions over the years. I'm saying to myself, how many times do I have to continue to disavow people?
So are you prepared right now to make a clear and unequivocal statement renouncing the support of all white supremacists?
Of course I am. Of course I am. I mean, there's nobody that's done so much for equality as I have.
Racism is evil, and those who cause violence in its name are criminals and thugs, including the KKK, neo-Nazis, white supremacists.
I've disavowed David Duke all weekend long on Facebook, on Twitter, and obviously it's never enough. I disavowed him every time I speak to somebody virtually, and, you know, they just keep it going, and
I totally disavow the Ku Klux Klan. I totally disavow David Duke. I've been doing it now for 2 weeks. This is, you're probably about the 18th person that's asked me the question. We are a nation founded on the truth that all of us are created equal. We are equal in the eyes of our Creator. We are equal under the law. And we are equal under our Constitution.
How many times do I have to reject? I've rejected David Duke, I've rejected the KKK, the Ku Klux Klan, from the time I'm 5 years old, I rejected them. And I disavowed then. I disavowed today on ABC with George Stephanopoulos. I disavowed again. I mean, how many times are you supposed to disavow? But I disavow, and hopefully it's the final time I have to do it.
On and on and on, and still you have this anchor on CNN denying that he ever rebuked David Duke and completely ignorant about the fact that it was a Hillary campaign that started this, and falsely asserts one more time that he was talking about neo-Nazis and white nationalists when he said there's good people on both sides.
And that's when we heard the words of the President of the United States that stunned the world and shocked the conscience of this nation. He said there were, quote, some very fine people on both sides. Very fine people on both sides? With those words, the President of the United States assigned a moral equivalence between those spreading hate and those with the courage to stand against it.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists.
He said there were, quote, some very fine people on both sides.
Now, elsewhere in those remarks, the president did condemn neo-Nazis and white supremacists. So he's not saying that the neo-Nazis and white supremacists are very fine people.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists.
Quote, some very fine people on both sides.
And I'm not talking about the neo-Nazis and the white nationalists, because they should be condemned totally.